In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a testimonials web page on your KW Command website where you can display the testimonials that you have collected through your testimonial page. So I've got another video that shows you how to collect the testimonials. I also have made you another video that shows you how to create the testimonial smart plan. So those are here with this video as well. And then if you go over to this webpage, understandcommand.com/testimonials, you'll see a step-by-step guide where I show you how to create each. So there's the video and step-by-step. And I'm going to add the video once this one is published here to this section. And then here's another video and a step-by-step on how to add the smart plan. Okay. So what you're going to do is we are going to go over to KW Command, and on the left-hand side, we're going to find Consumer. This used to be called Agent Sites, and now it's called Consumer. Click on Create a New Site, and then choose On My Agent Site. We want this testimonials display page to be on our agent site. Click Create Page. Now, you can go ahead and title it now or wait till the end, whatever you prefer. I'll title this Testimonials Display Page. Next, on the right, now you can design this any way you would like to. If you want to have, remember, this is going to be on your website already, so you don't need a branded header or anything like that because it's already going to be part of your website, so that branding will already be there, okay? So it's up to you now. If you want to just go straight into displaying the testimonials, we can start there, or if you wanted to add your team info or company profile for any reason up top, you could do that as well. There's a couple options. Right now we have a testimonials carousel and a testimonials list. You just simply click the widget and drag it in. And as you can see here, there are little arrows. So the user is able to click on each arrow to slide through all the testimonials. Alternatively, you could use the testimonials list, and that will display them in a row. Now, when we go to configure these widgets, we'll be able to choose which testimonials show up on this page. You also will be able to add testimonials to an existing page on your agent website. I'm going to let you know right now that when you save this page, if you want to edit it later, you actually go to Designs. Let me show you this because this people don't know this is here. So I'm not sure if they're going to change this back or not, but right now it used to be we'd go to Consumer and we would click on Agent Site Pages. We would be able to see all the pages on our website and we could click Edit. Well, as of right now, landing pages allow us to click the three dots and edit, but Agent Site Pages don't. So what I discovered was that they have moved them to Designs. So if you click on Designs and then Agent Site, these are now all the pages on your agent site. Find the page you created, which here's the one we just did, Testimonials Display. Click it and it will open, and now we can continue editing. Okay? All right. So the next thing we're going to do is after your page, you have all the widgets in here that you want to have, we're going to go ahead and click Configure Widgets. And the only widget we have to configure at this time is the testimonials list, because that's the only one we added to the page. So your headline would be something like, we want to hear, oh, this is our display, sorry. What our clients are saying. So you'll see here you have 60 characters. This is going to replace this here. It does not update in real time, so you'll have to add everything and then click at the bottom to update. So here your intro text. We are proud to serve Las Vegas, Henderson, and North Las Vegas. All right, I'm going to put a little call to action at the top of mine. And then client details is going to be what actually displays here in the testimonial. So it'll have their first name, their last initial, the city they live in, client since, like what date it was, and then the neighborhood, if you want to put that in there. So it collected their address, but it's actually pulling the neighborhood that they sold in. That's what that address is for. So you can choose to leave that in there or not. Anything you want or don't want, if you want it, leave it checked. If you don't, uncheck it. And then here you're going to select the testimonial. So right now I've only put in two. I'm actually adding a bunch today. So here we have Mike R. from Las Vegas. We have Rose L. And then here you could browse testimonials to enter more testimonials here. Now, I'm under the impression that we have a testimonials applet coming where we'll be able to access all of those. Right now, it's a simple collection, and then they make them available here on the anytime we're using the widget. So once you do that, you can see it update now. Looks great. And then we're going to click Save and Apply, and then Save Changes. Would you like to publish this on your agent site? Click yes. Now, the one more thing you need to do is add it to your site menu. So you're going to go to Site and App Settings. Next, you'll go to Site Pages, Add a Page, and find the page that you created, wherever that is. I'm just going to select this one for now. You can also go to create a new site and actually create one from this menu as well. Then click continue. You'll give it a page title, a URL slug, which in this case might be testimonials, and then the SEO description is it's about 160 characters, and it's a quick little description that looks like this. If somebody goes over to Google and they type in any information about you, these two lines of text right here, this is your meta description. This is that SEO description. So really, it's not there to help you rank on the search engines. It's there to help you have a proper snippet here, a proper description here on your snippet when somebody goes to Google and sees that little preview. So whatever you want to put there, you're going to put paste right there in your little description, okay? And then when you're done with all of that, you're going to click save page changes, and it will then add to your agent site. I already have mine in there, so I'm not going to add it a second time. And where that shows up now is when somebody goes to your KW agent website and uses the menu, they're going to be able to find that right there up there in your menu. So that is how you create your testimonials display page. I'm Lori Ballen. Please subscribe to the 365 Days of KW Command.